Hi, everybody, and welcome back to a brand spanking new episode of The Frost Bite. With me, your hostess with the mostest, and a cold, apparently. What are my other monikers? The cringiest crossdresser on YouTube. Your bestie who's a bestie. All of the above, and everything, everywhere, all at once. Honk, honk. Anyway, got some more Marvel Snap content coming at you. Now, it's my most played game right now. Over anything on PS5, don't have the new Xbox. I kind of went one system with this generation. But Marvel Snap's my most played game. I spend about $60 on it a month, full disclosure. I'm a dolphin. I mean, well, could be a whale. Anyway, so I love the game. I always get the season pass. That's where I stand on it. But the new season's coming out based on one of the most mid-level, mid-bad MCU movies, Eternals. Like the meme says, like, 10 movies have happened since this one and nobody's addressed this. It's sticking out of the fucking earth. Anyway, the next season, the June season, is going to be all about the Eternals, starting with the season pass card, Gilgamesh. 5/7 on reveal, plus one power for each of your other cards in play with increased power. Now, I'm a little baby, not so much whale, dolphin, little guppy, not even a guppy, I'm a piece of plankton in terms of the Marvel Snap content creator. So I know some people got clarifications on this card already, but potential, but it's a 5 cost. Turn 5 is very fucking crowded, especially with Blink, the season pass, Namora, which just came out today as of recording. So, but it's the season pass card. So, you basically get it for free with all the other, you know, the two variants, the mystery variants, all that kind of shit with the season pass. Season pass, if you play Marvel Snap and you're like, I'm proud to be free to play, no. Spend $10 a month on it. Just spend the $10 a month, get the season pass card. Get all the other stuff. If you're not spending money on the game, which is totally fine, I'm not saying you should, but I'm saying, like, if you can, if you just save $10 along the road somewhere and do the season pass. It's so fucking worth it. Honestly, seriously. If I only get one thing a month, it'll be the season pass. Every fucking time. Also, it'll save you some spotlight keys down the road if any of these are fucking bangers. Which, Gilgamesh, I don't think it's gonna be a banger. I don't think it's gonna be like Blink was this month. I think it's interesting, potential to get really high. It's on reveal, triggers with Wong. You can Grandmaster, which is just about to get buffed again. So there's all sorts of tricks you can do with this one, just like Namora, which came out today, which this might kind of replace that because it's every card, not just one at a location. So you're getting plus 4 power with a full location. Well, for him, well, not, it's the inverse. Totally fuck that up. He's the inverse of Namora because it's his location. But if you're increasing all your other cards, which you would want to, that's nothing but beneficial. So there's a lot of chemistry, a lot of synergy here with our boy Gilgamesh. And I don't know who this artist is. I should have looked it up before. I'm not digging the art. It's just so, it's the faces. It's just the fucking faces. It's the White Widow. It's got to be the same artist. It's just this awkward looking Picasso-esque face proportion. I don't know, not my favorite. No offense, you're a better artist than I'll ever be, drawing-wise. But, not my favorite art. Just don't like the art. Of course, there'll be some cool variants with the season pass, obviously. But on reveal, the ability, it's not a must-have, but you basically get it free with the season, with all the other shit you get on the season pass. So that increases its value or acceptability to me, being the season pass card. Because if it wasn't, I'd say skip, depending on what type of deck you want. Now, Athena, after each turn, plus 3 power if you played exactly 2 cards. So bounce, maybe even destroy on some level if you have the Deadpool killing thing going on at one time, and then you venom her up. All sorts of possibilities, but you have to play, if you don't play exactly 2 cards per turn, which we all know, Snap is very draw dependent, it's not gonna, you know, it's not gonna get as, she's not gonna get as big as you think. Now, it's not ongoing, it's not on reveal, so that's a cool thing, and it's only a 2 cost, so potentially the best 2 cost in the game, highest power 2 cost in the game, but that's a lot of requirements to maintain for the next 4 turns. Can it be done? Absolutely. Is it worth it with some of the other stuff in the meta and what's the other cards that are coming? Maybe not, but love the character, love, this is the season pass, not season pass, the spotlight variants, all these are going to be the spotlight variants, you can kind of see what those look like. I wish this was the main card, honestly, because it's that weird fucking face. especially with Cersei's. If you don't believe my Picasso comment was correct, go look at Cersei's. But anyway, Cersei, on reveal, transform your other cards here into random cards that cost one more. So it's like Blink, but the entire location. So it's cool. I love the chaos that this does, but it's competing with Blink. It's competing with Namor. It's competing with Gilgamesh. This 5/7 stat line, there's too many fucking options. Nerf one and, you know, to lower the cost, or buff one to raise the cost. Do something with these five cost power cards. Turn five is becoming the most important turn in the fucking game. I'm not here for it, but it's just happening all at once. It's not like the buildup over time. It's just like back to back to fucking back. So, but love the card, love the spotlight art. I'm down for it. What I'm not down for is this fucking piece of shit. Quicksilver 2.0. Like, this is how they should have buffed Quicksilver, to be fucking honest. Not make a new fucking card. But after this turn, runs from your hand to a random location, if possible. So, she's a 3/3. You'll never play her. She's a free 3 power at a random location, which there are locations you might not want that at, because maybe you're trying to maintain priority. If she was a 3/4, maybe. A free 3/4 is pretty badass, especially in a high Evo deck where you're trying to save energy. You're going to get that whatever turn. It's after the turn. It's not on turn 3. It's like, if this bitch is in your hand, it'll run in there after location randomly. So it could be a turn 1, 3/3 random location. Which, again, good or bad, I love the chaos aspect to it, but it's shit. This is the worst card of the month. Spoiler alert. And then we have my man, Fastos. On reveal, give each card in your deck -1 cost or +2 power. And it's on reveal. Turn 3, Fastos. Turn 2, Grandmaster. Profit. Whether it's the +2 or the -1, they're both fucking... I'll take either one. I don't mind it be random. You know, now some matchups, so to speak, would be better than others when this would hit. But, wow. Magnets. How do they work? But Fastos did it. He hit it with his big old hammer. Anyway, Fastos, amazing fucking card. I'm super excited for this one, not to spoil something, but I just fucking did anyway. But Fastos is badass. But, Arishem. At the start of the game, +1 max energy, shuffle 12 random cards into your deck. This card is amazing. It's probably the funnest card ever to come to Snap. The chaos, the fun. It's like draft, you know? It's like, in fact, there should be like a location where it says Ashram starts in your hand. And it's an expanded game of Snap. These mirror matches are gonna be fucking amazing. These are gonna be some of the best Marvel Snap matches you've ever seen. So that's why I love this card. But it's not for everybody. It is not for everybody. But fuck yeah, I want this fucking card. And look, the art, everything about this card is so fucking cool. Except Darkhawk. Darkhawk is gonna eat this shit alive. So you better hope out of the now 21 cards, 21, 22 cards in your fucking hand. Plus, what if you play Thanos? If you play Thanos, it randomly gives you Thanos. That's 6 more fucking cards in your goddamn hand. So the possibilities and the chaos is endless. It's incredible. And it's a 7/7. You'll never play it. Let's be honest. You will never put him down unless there's literally nothing else, which I don't see how that would, which I mean could be possible, don't get me wrong. But you will rarely play him. But you get 7 fucking energy. I mean, you get a +1 energy and all the randomness. I'm here for it. So what do I think of the June 2024 season overall? Now here's all the weeks they come out. Of course, Gilgamesh is the season pass card. Love the variant. The base card is fucking shit. But I say it's a fucking buy because it's the season pass. Seriously, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, children of all ages, the season pass is $10 and it's fucking worth it. Most of the time, the season pass cards are really fucking good. And again, they'll save you spotlight keys down the road. And you'll have the FOMO each month, you know? Just skip a fucking breakfast at McDonald's, skip a coffee one morning, and you've got your fucking $10 for Marvel Snap. And that's the whole month, not just a fucking 20-minute transit to your fucking place to go. So anyway, Gilgamesh, now if it was not the season pass card, skip it. It's up to you, which is what I think Thena is. It'll be June 4th with Gladiator and Grandmaster, but Thena's not on reveal, so... Grandmaster doesn't really come into play there with her specifically, but I think he will absolutely come into play with some other cards down the road here. But anyway, Thena, I'm on the fence. I'm honest with you, I'm on the fence. Like, I don't need her, but I kind of want her for the fun and also the possible variants that are going to come out. And then, you know, honestly, same thing with Cersei. It's like, I want this card, but I don't need this card. So it's really just going to come to, not full disclosure, I got like 15 spotlight keys. I'm still debating Nomura. So I might have way less than that by the time we get here. But nevertheless, I think Thena and Cersei are like, if you, you know, if your interest is 51%, go for it. If it's 49%, skip it and you'll be fine. But they're both exciting. I'm really happy for them. Unlike Makari, which is the biggest miss of the month. You know, she runs that fucking fast and can't hit the fucking mark. Sad. But anyway, good. And by the way, Cersei, of course, June 11th with Phoenix Force and Meek. I'm cool. I don't have Meek. I'm gonna be cool if I draw Cersei and I get Meek first. I'm not gonna complain because this card don't have, even though he's dropping, right? Or new season series 4. But June 18th, we got Makari. Everybody, nobody's gonna get this card. Only content creators are gonna get this fucking card in stands, which I fucking hate because the best spotlight variant of the month is fucking X23's Hellfire Gala look. I almost wanna spend at least risk 4 fucking keys to get X23's variant because it is fucking gorgeous. It is the variant of the month, which, again, so fucking tempted. So goddamn tempted. But the clear winner of the month that gets my award for the best card of the month, the one to spend your spotlight keys on no matter what, is Fastos. Now, of course, you also get Corvus in there. I don't have him. Looking forward to that. It's a win-win for me. Spider-Ham, cool variant. The Venomized variant is better, but it's still a good fucking variant. And Spider-Ham's a really fun fucking card. But Fastos, every card in your deck gets -1 cost or +2 power. That's fucking amazing. And it's on reveal. But it's turn 3. Surfer, it's gonna fit right in. Like, Surfer's gonna dominate that month. You're gonna see a lot of Cosmos, a lot of stuff like that to try to thwart the Fastos play, because it's gonna be what the Red Hulk was, or what was the big card? Last big card was the Red Hulk. That was like the, I think it was Red Hulk was like the huge one everybody fucking got. But anyway, Fastos, the best card of the month. I really should have, you know, in talking about Airshim actually out loud instead of in my head, I would switch this to a fucking, like, green check mark. Like, I've changed my mind talking about Ashram. It's not the card of the month because it's own archetype. Is it going to be fun? Yes. Is it going to be an amazing game of Snap to watch and one of the funnest you might ever play? Absolutely. The funnest fucking card in Snap. The mirror matches are going to be the wet dream of streamers. Absolutely. That's not subterfuge for anything. My nose literally fucking itches. Anyway, so yeah, that's my rankings for the month. When it comes to all that, and since I didn't click off the intro, it pops up again. So, by now, you should be subscribing right here to my cute little animated face. And up here is a video YouTube thinks you should watch based on all the other weird shit that you watch. So let me know what video that is down in the comments. All the YouTuber jargon, blah, 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 smash my like button. And until next time, stay fucking frosty.